Good morning, guys. So today is the day I finally get the keratin treatment. For years, you guys have been asking me about my hair care routines, and lately my hair has been super frizzy and really dry. So it's about time I start to take care of my hair. This video is sponsored by British Cosmetics, and they've been happy to collaborate with me for this because I thought it would be really helpful for you guys also to know a lot of information regarding the keratin treatment, what kind of products they use, and just everything you need to know regarding it. British Cosmetics is a place I've been to multiple times. I always go there to get my nails done. I got my hair cut there before, so it's a place I'm really familiar with. I feel at home there, I know the staff, and it's a really great place that I can recommend to you guys. So I'm really happy to be collaborating with them today. I have also used their products for a very long time. Their skincare range is amazing. I have not tried their hair care range yet. I might have to purchase a few today after the treatment. So we'll have to see. I'll also be giving you guys an update after I wash my hair, prices, side effects, benefits, everything that I went through. So yeah, keep on watching. And I'm here with Nishika, and she's going to talk us through the process and some of the products that they have. And I have a few questions to ask as well, some questions that you guys might want me to ask her. So let's get started.
Hello.
Hi, Nishika. I have a few things to ask you. Can you tell us a bit about the keratin treatment?
Yeah, of course. Well, it's quite popular these days in Sri Lanka, especially we get a lot of calls from people who call us and ask about what is the keratin treatment,
yes.
How does it work, and things like that. Mm-hmm. So, keratin treatment is basically a treatment. What we do is we're trying to get the hair, which is most probably damaged. We're trying
like
to get
mine. My hair is so damaged.
And we're just trying to get the hair back to its, give it a little bit more volume, give it a little bit more structure to it. Mm-hmm. So that's what.
And does this work for any hair type, or is it specifically for dry and damaged hair?
It's better on dry and damaged
right.
hair.
Okay.
Because for a, let's say for a healthy hair, yeah. keratin, the protein, needs to hang on to something.
Right. Yes.
So when hair is damaged, it soaks.
It absorbs that.
Yes.
Right. Okay.
It's open. The cuticles, mm-hmm. which is the like the outer layer of the hair,
yeah.
is open. So it has a place where I can hold on.
Right. Okay. And this, does the keratin treatment straighten your hair after?
Well, it's a now. It's sort of an after effect of when you do a keratin. What happens is we need to iron it very well for mm-hmm. us to get the keratin onto
right.
the hair shaft. So it's basically, we're giving it heat mm-hmm. To get the protein onto the hair shaft. That's why we need to iron it. So
right.
it's sort of an after.
And then after you wash it, does it kind of relax your hair? How does it depend?
Something like that. Let's right. say for hair like mine, it will take off the frizziness and
okay.
things like that. But it won't take off the curl itself.
Okay, that's good. So how long after the treatment can I use? Because I style my hair quite often. I blow dry it or I straighten it.
Yes.
Because I have to take a lot of pictures often.
Yes.
So how long after I get the treatment can I use heat on my hair?
Well, we ask you to take a break.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Sorry. Well, we ask you to give a break to your hair first of all, mm-hmm. maybe something like 2 to 3 days.
Okay.
So that the hair is much more relaxed.
Mm-hmm.
After any treatment, we ask the client not to do anything
to wait
the
a
hair.
Bit. Right.
Yes, because whatever the treatment, even if it's whatever said and done, if there's any chemical mm-hmm. concerns, if any chemicals are there in the product, we want the hair to sort of take it in, take the product
have that
in
time.
To have that,
yeah.
yes.
Yeah.
So that it's relaxed, more relaxed.
So make sure you just stay for about 4 days.
Yes.
A minimum of
well,
4 days.
Well, 2 to 4 is better. It
okay.
depends on the hair shaft as well.
Mm-hmm.
So we will have to give according to the client, we will have to give the correct advice.
Right. This question is probably going to be one of the most popular ones. What is the starting price range for the keratin treatment?
Oh, yes. It is quite a popular question.
Yeah.
Honestly, the reason why the keratin treatment is so expensive mm-hmm. is because the product is very expensive.
Right.
And the product is, I guess the reason that the product is expensive because the keratin has to be sort of taken out from either vegetables. Sometimes you find the synthetic keratin as
mm-hmm.
well. But according to studies, the synthetic keratin is not very reliable. Because of that, it's quite expensive. So
right.
because of the product expense, the keratin treatment itself is also expensive. So
okay.
the starting price, well, it will be something like 18-20 when it comes to the price range.
That's the starting. And also it depends on the length of your hair.
Length, volume, hair structure.
Okay.
Everything, it matters because even the hair structure, some people have really thick hair.
Yeah.
The absorption will be more than. So because of that, we can't say exact without looking at the hair, without feeling the hair, we can't give a...
So you would have to come in for a consultation before,
yeah,
and then kind of get your price range for your hair. So another popular one is, how long does the treatment last? Is it a monthly thing, a yearly thing, a weekly thing? How long?
Again, it depends on the hair and how damaged the hair is also. It will depend on that as well.
Okay.
Because usually, as I said before, this is a treatment. So what it does is, it's sort of coating the hair.
Okay. So do you have any idea about mine? Mine is so damaged, you guys. I have been using heat on my hair since I was like 15. So it's pretty damaged.
Well, my honest answer, not as damaged as we get usually.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Okay, because, that makes you feel better.
Yeah, because the damaged hair, we would say, is either rebonded and colored at the same time. So the hair basically just, when you touch it, it's sort of breaking off sort of.
Okay.
So that is like the damage what I'm referring to, like
okay. So it's not so bad.
It's
not as bad as I thought.
No,
okay,
no,
that's
it's not so bad.
So we have some products here
that
she's going to talk us through.
We need to prepare the hair shaft. So what we use is, we use a preparing shampoo, and what the shampoo does is, it will basically open the outer layer of the hair shaft.
I'll show you guys the products close up now, because once he starts to do the treatment, it will be hard for me to show you guys. So this is what it looks like. And where do you guys get the products from?
This is actually the Milkshake brand. Mm-hmm. So it is an Italian brand. Okay. Milkshake is
Italian.
We bring down the product from Italy. Well, mainly when we actually came across this product, which is very nice on the hair, which is even a hair color or even a straightening lotion or whatever the product and the milkshake is, you can see we are covered with milkshake all
yes,
over.
Yes, I know, because I haven't heard of this product before. And after I saw it on British Cosmetics on the Instagram, then I looked into it and it's a product that I would love to use. So I'm going to be using it for the first time today. So I'm also going to be telling them like my experience.
Definitely.
And after about 4 or 5 days after I wash my hair, and I think I will like it because I did check some reviews of milkshake products and they were all positive.
You will enjoy it immensely because I have been in this hairdressing trade for the past 13 years.
Wow.
And I have used so many products on my hair. I love to style my hair with color. I need a color. Without a color, I get crazy. So I have been using hair colors for such a long time and have used all the products that I can find in our country and overseas as well. But this color doesn't damage the hair.
Right. That's the most important
thing. That's the most important thing.
Yes.
For a hairdresser as well as a client, I guess, it's very important that the hair is not damaged, especially for a curly hair like mine. Once the hair is damaged, I can't set my curls. The curls don't set properly. So it's very, for about 1 or 2 months, I have this frizzy, messy look on my hair. So if the milkshake product, the main ingredient, even in the keratin treatment, the main ingredient is milk.
Ooh.
Yes.
So all these products are going to be used on me today?
Definitely.
Okay. So I think we should get started with our treatment. Definitely. Thank you so much for talking to us.
No problem.
And I'll show you guys in detail what we're going to do today. And let's get started.
Thank you.
Hi guys, so now it's day 4 since I got the keratin treatment, and I just went to the salon and they washed my hair for me and they dried it for me. And I thought that I would record this video as soon as I get home because we're heading out of Colombo tomorrow and I won't have any time to film this. So I'm going to talk you guys through some of the pros and cons that I faced after I got the keratin treatment and while I got it. If you have a sensitive scalp like me, it's going to hurt just a little bit when they start pulling your hair and when they start ironing it for the heat, because you have the product in your hair and then once they start ironing over it, sometimes it can hurt your scalp. This process was quite painful for me, but then there are a lot of people that don't feel any pain. I have a sensitive scalp in general, so that's why it probably would have hurt me. Wear comfy clothes because they're probably going to be seated there for over 3 hours. So make sure you're comfy and take a cushion if you want for your bag. Take a book with you, just anything to kind of keep yourself busy while you're staying there. Excuse my makeup right now, I did it in the morning and I went to the salon, I did a few things and now I'm back home. That's why it's a bit sloppy. Another con that I faced is staying for 4 days with the product in your hair, because it's like you have glue stuck onto your hair and you can't, it's really hard to brush it. You can't really tie it up and you just have to make sure doesn't get wet. Also online I saw that someone said make sure you don't even sweat, so it was really hard for me to kind of do that, having the dogs and just cleaning up and just even going out for anything. Make sure I kind of had those 3 days off where I was mostly at home, even though I was still sweating doing housework. It was kind of hard for me to control the sweating part of it, and it was so hard to stay without washing my hair for 3 days. On to the pros. Those are the only two cons that I faced with my sensitive scalp and not being able to wash your hair. For the pros, I have been using heat on my hair from the time I was 15, and then after I started doing shoots, they would use a lot of hairspray on my hair, back comb my hair, and my hair got quite damaged over the time. But I was happy to find out through this process that my hair wasn't as damaged as I thought it was, so that was a good plus point for me. But I definitely see a huge difference in my hair. Even when he dried it right after the shower, just drying it roughly with the blow dryer, my hair was already quite calm. Usually it's quite frizzy, it looks like a relaxed version of hot butter cuttlefish. I always say this, and then when I brush it out, it's more to the straighter side. Maybe that's why my hair is sitting straight right now. But he said after a couple of washes, it will kind of go back to how my natural hair looks like, but more healthier, it would be frizz free, and that dryness, especially how it looks after I iron my hair, it won't be there anymore. And this lasts for about 5 months. And the main goal, because I've always considered rebonding my hair, straightening it and doing all this relaxing soft bonding, all these kinds of things, and I was so scared that my hair would fall out of it, so I was like, maybe I should look into a treatment first to take care and nourish my hair if I could consider any of those things. And I'm so happy that I did, because I can definitely feel that my hair changed, and even when I touch it right now, it's so soft. You guys, I wish you guys can feel this. Tips on taking care of your hair after the keratin treatment: I would highly recommend use the conditioner and shampoo that your stylist would recommend. Please don't go back to using the shampoo that you have been using all these days. You have to definitely change your hair care routine, and these are the shampoos that I purchased. So this is specifically for the keratin treatment and after you get it done. I got the shampoo, as you can see. It's also by the same product, same brand, called Milkshake. And also the conditioner. So I'm really excited to use these products. I think I paid around 7,000, slightly over 7,000 for these two. I guess it's really worth the investment, paying for products just to maintain the treatment so that you don't use any harsh products that would wash the treatment out of your hair, because this whole process would be pointless otherwise. So definitely make sure you use a shampoo and conditioner that the salon recommends. The keratin treatment is also a treatment that I have been scared to get over the years. I have considered it. You guys have been asking me about my hair care routines, and frankly guys, I don't have any strict hair care. I was definitely excited to collab with the British Cosmetics because I have been going there for years. I know I already said this, but I did have confidence in them going in to get the treatment done, because a lot of places can handle your hair rough or they can just do it wrong. Kamal, who was doing my hair, he put a lot of work and effort into it, because once the product is in your hair, they have to constantly keep ironing it just to let your hair absorb the product, and it takes a lot of work. So that's why I was confident to collaborate with British Cosmetics, because I can definitely trust them, and I've been going to them for years before any collab started. This is a close-up of my hair. I don't know if you guys can see, but it's quite shiny, it's quite smooth. So my hair looks close up, and I've never had my hair looking this healthy in a very long time. And I highly recommend you wait at least 2 weeks before you can go swimming again, or before you consider even coloring your hair or using heat on your hair. Just let your hair breathe for 2 weeks, and then consider, always speak to your stylist and get advice from them. And I hope you guys were able to learn something from it. I hope I answered questions that you guys might have had. And I hope this video was beneficial to anyone who wanted to know about the keratin treatment. And I just love how my hair feels. Thank you, British Cosmetics, for collaborating with me. And yeah, I hope you guys like this video. And I will definitely give you guys updates on my Instagram. So make sure you follow me on my Instagram. I'll give you guys weekly or monthly updates on my hair. And I'll talk to you guys next Wednesday. Bye!